Assalamu alaikum students, how is your? I hope that you are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D1D2 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to chapter 10. We are going to start new chapter. It's Pythagoras Theorem and your book is D2 Math, New Syllabus Mathematics 2. Alright, so students, I'm going to explain you question number 1. Question number 1 is, find the value of the unknown in each of the following right angle triangle. Here these four parts are given. I will explain you two parts and you'll be able to do rest of the two parts. Okay, students, remember that for Pythagoras theorem, you just need right angle triangle. Here you can see that this is right angle triangle where one angle is equal to 90 degree. Here you can see that this is equal to 90 degree. And here, say this is straight line. So this is straight. This is angle is equal to 90 degree. And here, this is a straight line, so this angle is equal to 90 degree. And here, this is a straight line, so this angle is equal to 90 degree. So, you just need to remember that angle which is equal to 90 degree, the straight line which goes up is your perpendicular. The line which goes up is your perpendicular, and this is your baseline, and this is your hypotenuse. So, right angle triangle, you are having three sides, you are having three lines. So, the side which goes up, the line which goes straight up is your perpendicular, and this is your baseline. And this line, which is a slight curve, is your hypotenuse. Okay, so now I'm going to explain you the question. The first question is, your perpendicular is 20 centimeter, your hypotenuse is A and your base is 21. You have to find out the value of the unknown. So here unknown is A. So let me explain you this. Alright, this is exercise 10A. Okay, so you're here in this figure. Here this is the figure. As you can see that, this is the figure, this is 90 degree angle. So this line which goes up is your perpendicular and it's 20 centimeter. And this is hypotenuse which is A centimeter. And this is base which is 21 centimeter. Students, remember that this straight line is your perpendicular. This curved line is your hypotenuse. And this is your base. So the formula is that, remember that hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Now put the values. Hypotenuse is your A, so you take the square of A. Your perpendicular is 20, so you take the square of 20, and your base is 21, so you will take the square of 21. So A square you write on as it is. Now you will take the square of 20, so what you will get? 20 square will be equal to 400. Plus, when you will take the square of 21, so what you will get? You will get 441. Now you have to add 441 and 400. What you will get? You will get 841. Oh, students, here you can see that we have to find out the value of A. So, we don't need this square. So, to omit the square, what you need to do is you have to take the square root. So, take square root on both sides, as this is the rule that if you are taking square root on one side, you have to take the square root on the other side. So square and square root will cut each other. So just A is left over here. When you will take the square root of 841, what you will get? Square root of answer 841 will be equal to 29. So A is equal to 29. This is your answer. I hope that it's clear to you. Now let's move forward. Now I'm going to explain you part D. Okay, not D. I'm going to explain you part. Okay, D. So, D part is, this is your A part. Now, D part is, here you can see the figure. So, your D part is, here you can see that this is baseline and this line goes up straight up now. So, this is your perpendicular and this is your baseline. So, this baseline is 23. This perpendicular is 29 and hypotenuse is D. So, you have to find out the value of D. So, you'll put the formula. So, here this is D centimeter, which is your hypotenuse. This is right angle, na? So it means that this is a straight line, which is 29 centimeter. Straight line is your perpendicular and this is baseline, which is 23 centimeter. So this is your base. And this is, it means that this is your hypotenuse. Now you write down the formula that hypotenuse square is equal to the base square and perpendicular square. So hypotenuse is D, you will take the square of D and base is 23 square and perpendicular is 29 square. So D square will be equal to, when you will take the square of 23, what you will get? 23 square will be equal to 529, and 29 square, 29 square will be equal to 841. So d square will be equal to 841 plus 529. So it is equal to 1370. Again, you have to remove the square, so you take the square root. Square and square root will cut each other. So when you will take the square root of the, your answer, what you will get? Square root of answer will be equal to 37. So this is your answer. 37 meter. Centimeter. And again with A, you will write down centimeter. So these are your answers. I hope that part A and D of question number 1, this was question number 1. I hope that part A and D of question number 1 is clear to you. Okay, now let's move forward to question number 2. Okay, so question number 2 is, find the value of the unknown in each of the following right angle triangles. So here you can see that same figures are given, but here you just need to find out the unknown was given in a hypotenuse. So you just need to put the values. But here you will use the same formulas, but you can find out the perpendicular, or you can find out the base, or you can find out the hypotenuse by using the same Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so let's come to part A of question number 2. Part A, here you can see that this is right angle triangle. Now this is a straight line. This is a straight line, mean that this is your perpendicular. Okay, so your perpendicular is A meter. So first write down the values. Question number 2, A part, your perpendicular is A. Alright, now perpendicular is A, so this is, it means that this is your baseline. Base is 15 and hypotenuse is 39. Okay, base is 15 and hypotenuse is 39. Base is 15 A meter, base is 15 meter, and your hypotenuse is 39 meter. So now use the formula of Pythagoras theorem. So the formula of Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. Okay, so hypotenuse is 39, so you will take the square of 39. Base is 15, so you will take the square of base, and perpendicular you have to find out. Now take the square of 39, what you will get? So 39 square will be equal to 1521. Now take the square of 15, what you will get? 15 square will be equal to 225. So write down 225. And perpendicular you have to find out. Now this 225 is adding over here. When it will come to this side, will be subtracted with from 1529. We have to find out perpendicular, so we'll move this 225 to the left hand side like this. So P square will be equal to, when you will subtract 225 from 1521, what you will get? You will get 1296. So as I have told you that, okay, so as you know that you have to remove the square, so you have to take the square root. So let's take square root on both sides. Square and square root will cut each other, so the value of perpendicular will be equal to, when you will take the square root of 1296, what you will get? You will get 36. So your answer is 36 meter. I hope that it's clear to you. Now I'm going to explain you next part. Okay, so here you can see that now I'm going to explain you part B. Part B is here. This is a straight line. Again, you have to find out the perpendicular, and this is your base, and this is your hypotenuse. So again, you will use the same formula. Here, write down the values. Perpendicular is, this is part B. Perpendicular is B meter. Your base is 14 meter and your hypotenuse is 19 meter. Here you can see the values. Now let me solve it. Write down the formula of the Pythagoras theorem, which is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So hypotenuse is 19, so take the square of 19. Base is 14, take the square of 14, and this is what you have to find out. When you will take the square of 19, what you will get? 19 square will be equal to 361. And when you will take the square of 14, you will get 196. And P you have to find out. You have to find out P, so you will move this 196 to this side. So 361 minus 196 will be equal to perpendicular square. So perpendicular square will be equal to, when you will subtract 361 minus answer, you will get 165. As you have to take the square root, because you just need to remove the square. So you will take the square root on both sides. Square and square root will cut each other. And when you will take the square root of 165, you will get 12.8. So 12.8 meter is your answer. I hope that this lecture is clear to you. Do the practice of these sums, because when you will do the practice, then this concept will be more clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.